Good morning, children. Today we are discussing about irrational numbers. From the last class, we have studied about rational numbers. What are rational numbers? How can we represent them in a represent them on a number line, etc. You studied in lower classes. But last class you studied about rational numbers. Then what you studied? How to insert rational numbers in between the given numbers, isn't it? Today we are going to discuss about irrational numbers. Irrational numbers. What are irrational numbers? From the word itself, it's very clear. Not rational numbers, which are not rational. So we can define them as numbers which cannot be written in the form p by q, q not equal to 0, and p and q are integers, isn't it? For example, which are the numbers can be irrational? Those who are not rationals. So how can we find out those who are not rational? We can see that we can't find the value of root 2. We will get, but we don't get a finite value. We don't get finite value. That's why we can consider root 2, root 3, root 5, root 6. The product of prime numbers. All the square root of all prime numbers and their product, etc., are considered to be irrational numbers. Square root of 2, the least irrational. There are so many numbers, but commonly used one is root 2. Root 2, root 3, root 5, root 6, etc. are all irrational numbers. Similarly, the value of pi that you studied in case of mensurations of solids. So in this case, pi, the value of pi is also considered to be an irrational number. The value of pi is also considered to be an irrational number. You get the idea? You just get this idea only on this topic. Then we move to, when we move to the third topic, we will get more idea about irrational numbers. Now get the definition only, which are not rationals, and they can be, examples are pi. Pi is an irrational number. Similarly, root 2, root 3, root 5, root 6, etc. are all irrational numbers. Let us begin with it's a small construction actually, representation of root 2 on a number line. So to do this representation, you need your protractor, compass, scale, ruler, etc., isn't it? So let us begin. Root 2, representation of root 2 on a number line. Number line is very clear to us. We already studied in case of integers as well as in case of rational numbers. It's a line full of numbers. So let me start with somewhat middle. Let us start with 0 itself. Then on both sides, let me take 1 centimeter in our scale. That is considered to be 1 unit. 1 centimeter is considered to be 1 unit. Then here also, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, etc. Similarly on the right side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. Now I am not considering all the things, okay? I am considering because I need to represent root 2 on a number line. So in order to represent root 2 on a number line, actually you have studied about right angled triangles, isn't it? Right angled triangle means it's a triangle with one of the angle is 90 degrees. And when you consider about a right angled triangle, we have studied about there is a base, here is an altitude, and we studied about hypotenuse. See, right angle triangle. When you consider right angle triangle, the base. What is base? The side on which a figure stands. And altitude means 90 degree line drawn to the base. So this side is considered to be altitude. This is our base. And the longest side is called hypotenuse. So we know the relation between this one, base, altitude and hypotenuse, that actually you studied Pythagoras theorem. What is Pythagoras theorem? The sum of square on the hypotenuse is equal to sum of squares of these two. That is, hypotenuse square can be written as base square plus altitude square. Square on the hypotenuse is equal to sum of squares on the other two sides. So teacher is also applying the same theorem to draw root 2 on a number line. So for that, teacher has taken 1 unit distance. That 1 unit distance is considered to be my base. Now I am drawing an altitude from this one. An altitude whose height is also correct exactly 1 centimeter. Exactly 1 centimeter. This is 1 centimeter. Here is also teacher is taking 1 centimeter. So my base is 1 centimeter. My altitude is also 1 centimeter. Altitude means here 90 degree angle is required. That's why altitude. Okay. Then if you join this point 0 to this point, let it be B. Let it be B. Then you can see that according to Pythagoras rule, your OB is considered to be your hypotenuse. So OB square can be written as 1 square plus 1 square. Because we have taken base as 1 centimeter, altitude as also 1 centimeter. So equal to 1 plus 1 will give you 2 itself. Because square of 1 is 1 itself. 1 plus 1, 2. OB square is 2. So OB equal to root. OB equal to root 2. Then OB equal to root 2 centimeter. OB equal to root 2 centimeter. So hypotenuse square equal to base square plus altitude square. So OB square can be written as, according to this figure, we have taken 1 unit as base, 1 unit as altitude. So the length become OB. The length OB become how much we got it? Root 2 we got it. But the question is what? Represent root 2 on the number line. Now root 2 is lying here. This line only. We want to represent root 2. Here is required. So what you have to do is, taking your compass, keep your needle at O. Keep the needle at O. Then you draw and take this length as radius. With O as center, OB as radius, draw an arc like this. Draw an arc to complete the circle. With O as center, OB as radius, draw an arc like this. So this side we will get positive root 2 and this side we will get negative root 2. Is it clear? What are the things we did? We applied Pythagoras theorem. In order to get the length root 2. For that, for getting the length root 2, we don't know what is the value of root 2. That's why in order to get length root 2, we have taken the base as 1 centimeter and the altitude also 1 centimeter. Then we can see that using Pythagoras theorem, length OB become root 2. Then take this root 2 in your compass. With O as center, OB as radius, complete an arc, semicircular. It touches both sides on the number line. So one side, right side, we have positive root 2. On the same left side, we have minus root 2. Is it okay? Next, representation of root 3 on a number line. Same method. First step is same. First, let us draw a line. Somewhat middle, we can keep O 0, then 1, then 2. Then 3, etc. You can mark. And here negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, etc. You can mark it on your left side. Now we need, in the previous case, it was root 2. But in this case, we have to consider root 3 required. So I told you, we need Pythagoras theorem to get the value of root 3. So what we do to get root 2, root 3? What we do? That 3 is actually, look at here, 3 is actually, root 3 is given to us. Suppose you consider your hypotenuse. Our theorem is hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus altitude square is given. We know it's understood. So instead of hypotenuse square, we can write, suppose you consider root 3 as your hypotenuse, we can write root 3 square, we can write. Then what we write root base and altitude, what we write? Root 3 square is actually 3. How can we obtain 3? We can obtain 3 using 1 plus 2, isn't it? 3 can be obtained using the sum of 1 plus 2. 1 plus 2 together will give you 3. So you square this one also. 1 square is 1 itself. So we can write. But 2 is square of what number? Root 2 is required. Given, we need to reach the value of root 3. So they have given root 3. That root 3 is considered to be hypotenuse. So instead of hypotenuse square, teacher has written the given number square. Root 3 square is written. But we don't know how to fill these two. So what we are doing is root 3 square is 3. And we know 3 can be written as sum of 1 plus 2. 1 means 1 square itself. But 2 means square of root 2 is needed. So what we need? Our base as 1 or altitude as root 2. Or reverse order also. You can take base as root 2 and altitude as 1 degree. Base as root 2 and altitude as 1. Both methods are applicable. But now teacher is showing you like this. When base is root 2 and altitude is 1. When base is root 2 and altitude is 1. So let us begin with how we first what we do to obtain root 2. Because we need base as root 2. So for that take this one unit only. And draw an altitude. You can use your protractor to draw the altitude. So this is 1 centimeter. This is also 1 centimeter. So this will give you. Here I am drawing with dotted lines for your convenience. This dotted line shows you root 2 centimeter that we studied just now. After getting this root 2 centimeter, again root 2 is considered to be your base. So we need altitude. Altitude how much centimeter? 1 centimeter again. So using your protractor, keep your protractor on this root 2 centimeter, that is OB. Keep your protractor on OB. And draw 90 degree line like this. Let it be of length 1 centimeter. Here comes a point C. Then you join O to C. The length OC is equal to root 3 centimeter. Length OC is root 2 centimeter. First we have taken 1 centimeter and altitude 1 centimeter. Then we joined OB. OB is root 2. That root 2 is considered to be our base. So now keep your protractor on OB, make an angle of 90 degree at B, that is BC. How much length needed? 1 centimeter length needed. Then you join OC. After joining OC, you can see that OC is of length root 3 centimeter according to Pythagoras theorem. Now what you have to do is same as previous one, keep your needle at O and radius as OC. Keep the needle at O, radius as OC, take a compass. Draw an arc like this. Draw an arc like this. And this is somewhat near to 2. Somewhat near to 2. This value is considered to be positive root 3. And on the left side it is minus root 3. Is it okay? Is it clear? Go through the video once or twice. Then only you will get the idea. And your homework question is, you have to do a homework after this. Try yourself to represent root 5 on a number line. If you are not getting, teacher will explain through another video. Okay, thank you.